Good afternoon, YouTube. You may remember from a couple weeks ago, or maybe it was a week ago, I went on a drive and got a bunch of big rock chips on the car. Yeah, I'll show you those right now, one second. So you can see here's a big boy right there. There's that one right there. You got this one right there. And that one's particularly nasty. I got a couple others that are on the sides of the car that I'm going to take care of. So I bought a little kit called Dr. Colorchip. And so I'll show you what's in here in a second. And I already tested the kit. I bought another identical kit from my wife's car and touched up a bunch of the rock chips on her car first. So I'm not totally crazy. I'm not going just straight to touching the paint on the Ferrari because that would not be good, or at least I'm a little bit too nervous to just go straight and do that. So let's open up this box and I'll show you exactly what we're gonna be doing, okay? All right, so like I said, this is the Dr. Colorchip paint repair kit. I Googled a bunch of stuff about how to fix paint chips, and this stuff seemed to be highly recommended. There's a couple other guys who have some supercars that are using this stuff, so I felt pretty comfortable after watching them use it on their cars. So inside the package, gives you a microfiber towel, you got a little glove, and this lint-free towel, and then of course we got the actual paint, which is color matched. So my paint code is 322, so that's the Rosso Corsa red. It's got little paint brushes, and then this special chemical that blends the paint or whatever, so we'll go through that in just a minute and show you how to do this. So the first thing that we're going to do is prep the surface. Basically, we want to get rid of any possible contamination. The way we're going to do that is I have a spray bottle. It's full of some rubbing alcohol, basically, and then I have a microfiber towel. So I'm just going to give it a little tiny squirt, and then make sure that there's no dirt in there. Get that nice and clean. All right. So the next thing we're going to do is take the paint, and we're going to shake it up pretty good. You can. It's got the little rattlers in there. Just want to make sure it's nice and shook up and doesn't have any globs in it and stuff like that. All right, now that we got the paint shook up, we're gonna take the little brush and we're gonna dip it in the paint, get a decent sized glob of it. And here's where you're gonna think I'm crazy. You actually take and put a big old drop right next to what you're trying to actually cover. And you take your thumb and you just smush it right over it. And then you can see it's partly covered, it's still got a little bit to go, so I'm gonna take a little bit more paint, put another dab, and then I'm gonna smear it again on it. You can see it's pretty well covered. We'll let that dry for a little bit. And I'm gonna go do the other ones, so let's go look at one of the other ones. All right, so you can see that this one's pretty large, so I'm gonna have to put pretty good sized glob of paint. So I'll put it right above it. And then I'm gonna smear that right into it. And I'm gonna do the same thing right here in this guy. Put it right next to it and then smear it right in. There. All right, again, let that dry. All right, now the instructions say to wait until it's dry to the touch, which you can see it pretty much is dry to touch. But this one is such a big divot. I'm actually gonna give it a little bit more paint. I found it on these big ones, you actually gotta kind of take the brush and just dab a tiny bit right into the divot. Basically build up a little layer like that. All right, and I gotta do that in these other ones, so. All right, so you can see it's now dry to the touch, which only takes about 2 minutes. So now we're gonna use the, I guess it's called the seal act, whatever, the step two. You gotta first, you can see it's separated. So we need to shake the crap out of this guy first. All right, now it's all shook up. We're just gonna take and put a little bit of it on this cloth, on the lint-free cloth. You can see a whole lot. Just gonna very gently start rubbing this. And basically what's gonna happen is the chemical is gonna dissolve the paint. But by not putting much pressure, we're going to just dissolve it
in the top layer, so it's going to remove all the excess, but hopefully the divot itself won't actually dissolve. And the way we do this is we put extremely light pressure on it. We just keep rubbing. There, so we got all the excess paint off. Now we did that, we're gonna take the microfiber, one second. I'm gonna take the microfiber and just kinda remove all this excess chemical. There. So, you can see right there, that's where the chip was. And it's already dry, and it already looks pretty good. So, let's go on to the next one. Do the next one. So, right there, you can see the excess paint. So again, just take our little guy. Let's move it to a new section so it's clean. Put a little this chemical on there. And then we start rubbing. It's kind of hard to see, I think, on the camera, but when you're in person, you can see the discoloration from the new paint. And so when you're rubbing, you can see it starts to pull away the new paint and leaves behind just a slight discoloration where so it's kind of hard to see, but it starts to break up. All right, so I don't know if you can see this, but. So you can kind of see the discoloration, right? And then it kind of almost like starts to break up. So I'll keep, again, you want to use really flat, fairly light pressure. So. Oh, here it comes, there. All right, got that one. So now, again, we just take the microfiber and kind of buff away all the excess chemical. And there it is. And so you'll see it'll dry better color matching. So it'll take a little bit, but yeah. All right, so we got that one. We're gonna just start polishing away. See, it's looking pretty good. All right, let's do another one. All right, we got that one taken care of. You can see right there. It's not too bad. All right. Let's see, here's where this one was. It's pretty hard to see. Where is it? Shoot. I think. It was this. I'm not 100% sure. That may have been when I was already there. This one for sure. You can see it's pretty hard to see it. Came out pretty good. This big guy right here, he's still got a dent in him. So I'm trying to see if you can kind of see when the light goes there. Yeah, there you go. So this one I'm going to put another layer in a second. That one, it was pretty deep, so it's going to take a little bit of effort. The ones down here, this big chip right here, it's actually pretty good. I mean, it blended in pretty good. You can see it when I get the light just right. Yeah, so it's not bad. I'm pretty happy with that one. And the ones actually on the other side of the car, let's go over here. Had a couple little door ones. They're almost invisible. So there's one right there. And I don't know if you can even see it. That one's really good. This one was kind of like a imperfection, the paint. So I don't know if I could do much with that. There was one that was... crap, I can't even see it. That one came out really good. And then I did a couple of chips on the inside of this, and those look pretty good too. So you get an idea. It actually works really well. I'm gonna go give that one in the front another pass, and let's see if that makes it look any better. All right, so I made the second pass, and now this one's almost perfect. You can barely see it. This one, where is it? There you go. He's pretty darn good. You can see if you get it just in the right light. Let me see. Yeah, right there. There you can see it. This one up here, this one's having a hard time. Let me see if I see there. When the light passes over, you can see the little divot. But the paint color's pretty good. And actually, after the second pass, this one's not bad. Certainly a lot better than it was, you know. I wasn't expecting perfection, so I think I got exactly what I expected out of it. So yeah, I mean, I guess the big thing is I'm just trying to, you know, show you that this little Colorchip kit for $45 or something like that did a good job. I mean, you know, anytime you got paint chips like that, it's never gonna look perfect again. You're gonna have to get the whole thing repainted to have it look perfect. So yeah, I'm content, and would definitely recommend it. So hopefully, I might do another layer or two. I'm gonna let it sit, see what it looks like in the sunlight, and that should give it a better indication of how perfect it is or not. But again, I don't think it's gonna be close to perfect at all. So now that's done kind of getting touched up, according to instructions, you're supposed to wait, I think, 3 days before you wax the car. So I'm not gonna wax it, I'm not gonna do anything. It did say it's ready to, you know, it's immediately okay to be in water and rain. So I'm actually gonna, you know, go over with some Showtime, just kind of make sure that there's no blemishes or dirt that I may have stirred up. So but yeah, I think it's looking pretty good. So because I want to use the paintbrush later to repair any other chips, basically I took some 100% acetone, poured it into the cap, put it in there, shook it, you know, stirred it around a little bit, and then just dried it off on a paper towel, and this brush will be good to go for the next time. You can see it's not going to obviously get rid of, you know, all the paint off of it, but it'll at least leave it good enough so it's not going to harden to a crisp. So yeah, again, that stuff's called Dr. Colorchip. So yeah, I definitely recommend it, and thanks again for watching, and don't forget to subscribe, and we'll see you next time.